Hi, I'm Ron Husen, Vice President of Platform Products here at Bitware. I'm in our engineering validation lab with our first VU13P D2104 packaged littlest ultra scale plus device. So while these are mechanical samples I'm taking out of the package, the actual real production chips are currently at our contract manufacturer being assembled onto the first prototype boards. So with the VU13P, we're moving to the lidless package. And what that means is they've taken off the actual lid that usually goes over the device to help with thermals. So with this device, with the VU13P being the largest ultrascale plus device available on the market with about 3.8 million logic cells, that's about 50% bigger than the VU9P, which we're currently shipping to most of our customers. And while ultrascale plus is very power efficient, with that much logic and the high speeds it can be run at, you can end up with a fair amount of heat. So having the lidless package allows us to directly connect our heatsink device to the top of the die to buy us some extra thermal capability in terms of how hot we can run the part and our ability to cool it. Putting this part on our board, there's actually in the D2104, they've also optimized the pinout for thermal and power. The other advantage with the 13P with the large onboard logic is also a huge amount of onboard memory. So with 360 megabits of ultra RAM as well as 90 megabits of block RAM, it provides over 450 megabits of onboard memory,
which is the fastest memory available and the lowest latency.
So the upcoming HBM2 devices will have 8 gigabytes of onboard memory. However, they are DDR4 SDRAM essentially, so while they're extremely high bandwidth at over 460 gigabytes per second, they are not low latency. So depending what you want in your system, whether you really need the memory bandwidth or whether you're looking for latency and determinism, will decide whether you want the VU13P with its logic and memory or the HBM2 devices. We're putting this part down on our Viper platform board. The first board will be the XUPVV4. This board's been designed for thermals. It has 4 large DIMMs for up to 512 gigabytes of DDR4. We also do custom QDR SRAM modules that can plug into the DIMM sites. Each one has 576 megabits of QDR2 plus SRAM. As well, the XUPVV4 has 4 QSFP28s for up to 4 100 gigabit Ethernet interfaces, or 16, 10, or 25 gigs. Finally, the board has 2 UltraPort SIM/SLASH connectors, which have 8 lanes of 25 gig SerDes, which can be used for an additional 4 100 gigabit Ethernets. They can be adapted for OpenCAPI with Power9, or they can be used for board-to-board connections. So while these are mechanical samples I'm holding in my hand, the actual devices are at our manufacturing facility currently being put on boards. We should have them back in the lab in a few weeks and hopefully be shipping to customers in a couple of months.